You idiot, you stupid idiot. We had her, she would have gone to Blackmore.
Oh, great, I would have been out of a job. I couldn't press charges. She said it. She said she'd have me before the board for what I said to that black bitch, Wes. Ah!
You never learn, do you? There will be no racist remarks, not in my prison.
What the hell is the matter with you people? She's just a bum!
What do you want?
I've just closed the shop. Do you want me to put the coffee?
Put it by the urn. Any trouble?
Yes, you were right. Jenkins has stopped me from buying contraband. I can do about it.
Well, that's it then. You may as well close the bloody thing.
What about the other deal?
Jenkins didn't like it, but she didn't stop them from buying legal goods. She's really got them trained.
Has she? Has she got them trained? Have you got your baton?
No.
Well, get it.
Oh, what's happening? Who's holding me?
I'm surprised at you, Lurch. Stopping the women from buying alcohol and then sneaking in here for a pre-dinner.
What are you doing?
What would the women say if they found out?
I'm sorry. It's just everything's getting too much.
I know, it's Ferguson. She's really got us on a string, hasn't she? Here.
Have we got enough?
Oh, who cares? You deserve it. I don't think I could have done all this without you. In fact...
What?
I'm sorry. I'm just making things worse for both of us.
Doing a bit of overtime, are we, Maxwell?
Well, you said...
I know what I said. You can go back now.
Will she be safe? What if she goes back before they find Jenkins?
They have already found Jenkins. Would you please leave the thinking to me? As far as the other women are concerned, you and Maxwell have been out here all the time. Now, get going. Mr. Adams. Make a note of it, will you? You can have it for staff price.
I stand up in front of everybody and ban the contraband from the shop, right? Next minute I'm found stinking of booze and everyone thinks I'm drunk. Then Maxwell starts doing something she said she'd never do.
Of course, giving credit, she never does it. Remember when you tried to make a bet, Lisa?
Morning, ladies.
Oh, good morning, Mr. Jackson. Why didn't you tell us all this last night?
I did.
Look, if you would have told us this last night...
Quit hassling me, will you?
I'm not hassling you, I'm your friend.
Well, pity you didn't remember that last night. I could have done with a mate.
Hey, son, what are you trying to do, kill me?
Quit griping, will you? She's alone. We can get her.
Maxwell, where?
I just saw her get stuff from the laundry to clean the shop. She's out there now.
No screws?
She's a trustee, remember? Come on, let's get her.
No way, you stay here.
I'll give it a
go. No!
Right, here are my notes. This is the speech. I want you to concentrate on the reform...
Just a minute, Mr. Dwyer. I've already prepared my speech.
Good Lord, why? I mean, I explained this all over the phone, didn't I?
All you said was that you wanted me to talk
about... Give the speech. My speech. Well, I can't do it, can I? I can't stand up there and praise the department. I am the department.
I see. I didn't realise.
Well, it's quite simple. All you do is concentrate on the reforms that we have put through in the last year.
It shouldn't take long.
Now, listen, Mrs. Reynolds.
No, Mr. Dwyer, you listen to me. I'm sorry, neither Craven nor Bennett would deliver your paper. Well, neither would I. You've got every right to edit my speech, but no right to expect me to do what you're asking.
All right, let's see it.
Connors, you're not thinking. What are your friends going to say when they see you wrecking this shop, eh?
Why, the only thing I'm wrecking is her.
Not true. What about this shop, eh? And this one.
Get up.
Get up. Get up.
Connors.
You're very foolish, Connors. Assaulting an officer yesterday and now this.
You bitch, Ferguson, this is a setup. It's a bloody setup.
Mr. Adams, contact the department. Tell them that in my capacity as acting governor, I am transferring Rita Connors to Blackmore immediately.
You bitch! It's a setup! It's a bloody setup!
Something must have happened. She wasn't at lunch.
Oh, stop going on about it, will you? Connors is big and ugly enough to look after herself.
Oh, jeez. Hey, who was on second sitting? Anyone seen Reed?
Well, she's probably following your example.
Meaning what?
Gone off somewhere to get smashed. Huh? Maybe she started pining for a Bung friend and got herself put back in the pound so they could be together.
She'll be disappointed if she did. Bung's already been let out. I saw her a while ago on cleaning duty.
Hey! That's good thinking. Any garbage lying around, she'd just pick it up and eat it.
Oh. I don't know where Kathy is. She's been gone ages. I'm going to look for her. All the more reason to worry about Reed.
Everything all right in here, ladies?
No. Do you know where Reed is? Oh, I'm sure you'll all be told in good time. Something's happened then.
I never said that.
You said we'd all be told. Told what?
There is no reason for you women to concern yourselves about anything.
Oh, I still reckon we ought to be told. Jeez. Do you see any sign of her when you're on tray duty, Laurie?
No. She must be in isolation. She has to be.
Bloody hell. Oh, the screws must have sprung her having a go at Maxwell. Jeez, there's got to be some way we can find out.
I can't believe you're serious.
What you believe doesn't interest me in the slightest.
Joan, I'm not going to let you do it.
And how do you propose stopping me? Are you forgetting who's in charge here?
You're the one who can never get that straight. Anne is head of this prison, not you.
Ah, but she's not here, is she? She's off at her Bleeding Heart Prison Reform Conference. I am in charge.
You are deliberately rushing this through because you know Anne won't have a bar of it.
Oh, I think I'm doing precisely what she would expect me to do. She's warned Connors often enough. Any more trouble and it's Blackmore.
She might have had that in mind as an absolute last resort. However,
since
I don't...
Since when were you an authority on what the governor thinks?
It's more knowing how you think. You've been waiting for
this chance. I have done what any self-respecting governor would do. Now, that woman tried to destroy a prison facility and kill another inmate. I am quite sure that Maxwell would have been dead if I hadn't arrived when I did.
That's nonsense.
And I say it's not. I've got Adams and Jackson's statements to back me up, not to mention the damage in the shop and the photographic record and the catalogue of damage. I have gone by the book all the way.
Then why the rush? Why don't you wait till Anne gets back if you're so confident that she'll back you?
Because we all know just how much trouble Connors can stir up given half a chance. I want her out of here before the other women get wind of it.
What's wrong with keeping her in solitary?
And what's wrong with obeying orders, Morris?
It seems to me Mrs. Reynolds is in a very difficult position. She's expected to produce results while your government continues to deny her basic facilities. Would you say that's a fair assessment?
What I would say is that I don't want this issue to become a political football just because this is an election year.
Yeah.
I'm simply stating facts. Without some departmental backing, this program will collapse and Wentworth will end up another Blackmore.
No one can say this government hasn't been supportive of Wentworth. We've just spent a significant amount installing a shopping facility for the prisoners, something I regard as an important initiative by my department.
That's true, not to mention several other reform projects the minister and I have discussed.
Oh, what kind of projects?
Well, I wouldn't care to say too much at this stage, but yes, we do have some things in the pipeline.
Well, I'd be interested to see what you have in mind.
Excuse me, Mrs. Reynolds. Phone call for you from Wentworth.
I did leave a message. I wasn't to be interrupted.
Yes, it's a Mrs. Morris. She did say to apologise, but it is important.
I'm sorry. Would you mind excusing me?
Of course not. Go ahead. I can assure you, anyone who thinks our commitment to reform is just so much window dressing is very much mistaken.
This is it, Connors! They say a change is as good as a holiday! We might have become friends eventually!
You bitch! You bitch! You had to wait till Reynolds' back was turned, didn't you?
That's right!
Hey, Pete, what's going on?
What's she doing?
They're taking me to Blackmore! Tell everyone! I'm in set up!
Inside! I told you to keep all out of sight!
It's not my fault!
We're just set up! Blackmore, you hear me?
Let me kill you,
Munro! All right, you little bitch, you're on a charge.
Hurry up, Adams!
They take Henry to Blackmore, so I've done something!
She's all yours, but watch her.
No worries.
You bitch, Grayson! You're not going to get rid of me that easy! You wait up a second, remember? Bitch and cowardly mongrel! You bitch!